Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another example of how to find the limit of a sequence. The sequence we're given is a sub n, which is the representation of the sequence, equal to the quantity n squared minus n plus 7 divided by the quantity 2n cubed plus n squared. So in order to find the limit of this sequence, because it's in the form of a rational function, we've got a fraction here, the easiest way to go about finding the limit is to divide through this whole fraction by the variable n, but raised to the highest degree that we find in our function. So in this case, n cubed is our highest degree variable. So we want to divide through by n cubed. And the reason is because we want to take n out of the numerator and put it in the denominator. And I'm not talking about the numerator here and denominator here, but instead the numerator and denominator of each particular term. So for example, this n squared term is n squared divided by 1. We want n in the denominator where the 1 is instead of in the numerator where the n squared currently is. If we divide through by n cubed, we'll end up with 1 over n, right? So n would be in the denominator of that particular term. That's what we're going for, and the reason is because we're finding the limit of this sequence as n approaches infinity, and we'll talk in a second about why we need to plug infinity into the denominator instead of the numerator. So like I said, we're going to divide through every single term in this fraction by n cubed. So it's the same thing as multiplying by 1 divided by n cubed. So when we do that, we'll take n squared and we'll divide by n cubed. That'll leave us with just one n in the numerator, in the denominator of that particular term. We will take n and divide it by n cubed and we'll end up with n squared in our denominator here. 7 over n cubed will stay just as it is. 2n cubed divided by n cubed just leaves 2. And then n squared divided by n cubed leaves us again with 1 over n. So now you notice that wherever the variable n exists, it's in the denominator of its own, of whatever, you know, term we're talking about, instead of in the numerator. And like I said before, the reason that we want to do that is because now we're going to take the limit of the sequence as n approaches infinity, which means that we're going to plug in infinity everywhere we see n in our function here. If we were to plug infinity into this function here, with, you know, n squared, n like this, and n is in the numerator of each particular term, the function becomes really difficult to work with and we can't solve it. If we get n into the denominator of every term, whenever we plug in infinity, that term, if n is in the denominator, is going to approach zero. 1 divided by infinity is 0. 1 divided by infinity squared is going to be 0. Whenever we have infinity in the denominator, that term is going to approach 0. So that'll mean that we can we will have a much easier time simplifying this fraction. So that's why we're going to do it. And if you have trouble remembering what 1 divided by infinity actually is, you can always plug in like 1 divided by, you know, 10 million or something into your calculator, and you'll get a very, 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 very small number, or it might even round it to zero for you, and you'll see that it's zero. So if you, if you're, you know, taking a test and you can't remember, you can always plug in a very large number for n to see what you get. But anyway, so when we plug in infinity for n, remember that whenever n is in the denominator, that term's going to become zero. So we'll get zero for this first term, we'll get zero for the second term, and we'll get zero for the third term. And then in the denominator, 2 will stay as it is, and we'll get 0 for this second term here in the denominator. So as you can see pretty quickly, we're going to have 0 in our numerator, 0 minus 0 plus 0. So of course it doesn't matter what's in the denominator because 0 in the numerator means that our final answer is going to be 0. And that's correct. The limit as n approaches infinity of this particular sequence is 0. So 0 is the value that the sequence approaches as n goes to infinity. So anyway, I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video.